How many of you have been bullied? Did they say things like, no one likes you or you're so stupid? Were you ever scared to go to school? For those of you who haven't been bullied, imagine being scared to go to school, afraid that as soon as you walk out of your house, you would no longer be safe, helpless when the time comes where the bullies see you. Bullying is all around us. Make it stop. It's not just in real life. There's cyberbullying. Cyberbullying is real. Stand up and rise above this kind of bullying. You might say that people say just ignore it, but it's not that simple. Being silent can give the bully what they want. I had a friend and she made someone cry with her words, not by physical bullying, but by the mental game that many bullies use. It's fake crying, Lauren, she told me. And she also gossiped a lot. She bossed us around and tested to see if you were a good friend. Like me, 27% have been or are currently being bullied. 21% have witnessed and 28% are unaware. Do what you can to be the 28% that are aware. Did you know that suicide is the third leading cause of death among young people because of bullying? You may not think saying, you're stupid, or seriously, you're such an idiot, is bullying, but people can take it that way. We can address this issue for the people who are too scared to stand up for themselves by seeing the changes in them, such as in eating habits like suddenly skipping meals, declining grades or not wanting to go to school, sudden loss of friends or not wanting to be social, feelings of helplessness or decreased self-esteem. Whether you have been bullied or you are the bully, think about what a person could be going through. Think before you speak and be kind. Together, no matter who you are, we could change someone's day by giving them a simple smile, or instead of saying, how was your day? Dig a little deeper. I have seen people being bullied. I have seen people stand up for one another. And I have seen people change because they stood up. Stand up, speak up, stop bullying.